So we looked in quite some detail at the self and the body separately. I just wanted to make that comment again that the self is that whole field of consciousness, while the body is material. And really speaking, if we look at it closely, the self is the one that is central to human existence. And the body is just being used as an instrument of the self. So if we look at the transaction between the self and the body sends some signals to the self in the form of whatever pain signals or hunger signals or some information is sent from the body to the self in the form of signals. And the self then sort of processes this information, takes it up, and comes to some decision based on whatever processing it does. And after the self comes to some decision, it gives certain instruction to the body, and then the body does whatever the self has instructed it to do. So, but all this happens so fast that we are not aware of it. So we feel that, things are happening automatically, but we can explore this. Here we are going to focus on the feeling of self-regulation in the self. So, what is this feeling of self-regulation? This is a feeling which is not like a control, but a feeling of responsibility towards the body for nurturing, protecting, and rightly utilizing the body. So, if we look at the needs of the body, we said, the body needs food, the body needs clothes, all physiochemical things, and so on. So if we look at these this feeling of self-regulation, this feeling of responsibility of the self towards the body, then we can see it is responsible for the nurturing, protection, and right utilization of the body. So we'll take your reflection on this. Is the physical facility required for nurturing, protecting, and right utilization? Can we have that reflection, please? Akhilesh? Am I audible? Hello?
Yeah, ma'am,
Huh.
you are audible.
Huh. Can we have that reflection, please? Meanwhile, we'll just take an example of, like what we were mentioning, that the self is central and the body is just a sort of an instrument of the self. So if we take an example, every day, when we are when it's time for breakfast or lunch or dinner, the body sends some hunger signals to the self, and then the self reads those signals and then comes to a decision to give the body food. So then the self, caters to the body in terms of the food for the body. But you may be able to observe that something different happens if you keep a fast. So the body still sends the signals at the same time, for breakfast, lunch, dinner. But now the self has pre-decided something. So, based on that, even though the body sends the signals for lunch, the self decides not to give food to the body. And then the body manages, the body doesn't have any problem as such because the self has taken that decision and is using the body like an instrument. Similarly, we can take another example. Like if you go for a long walk and midway the body sends some pain signals to the self because of the long distance that the body has walked. Now, supposing you have some important reason to come back, then you might decide to stop the walk midway and come back home. Supposing you have free time, you might decide to continue to walk for a little more distance, or you might decide to sit down, take rest for some time. So the self basically decides and then the body follows. I don't see the reflection. Can we see the reflection? Akhilesh?
Adindi, we can see the reflection.
Oh, I'm not.
It is there.
Oh, I'm sorry, I'm not able to see it.
Okay. So 69% of people are saying that this is true, huh. And 31% people are saying that this is not true. Okay. Or the other option. You also need it for other objectives in life. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So it's nice. At least, you know, majority are able to see that this is true, that we, you know, self has to have this. So this self-regulation also leads to health of the body, which we'll discuss a little later. So we are saying that physical facility is required to fulfill the responsibility of the self towards the body, to keep the body in good health, and for nurturing, protecting, and rightly utilizing the body. And this required physical facility can be identified. So we can, you know, see whether we can identify this, quantify it or not. So supposing we look at food to nurture the body. So, you know, one person might eat 1 kg in a day of grain. Another person might eat 0.5 kg of grain in a day. Somebody who is a manual laborer or who does more work might eat 2-3 kgs of grain in a day. But we can see that we can quantify this. We can, you know, there may be different people may have different needs, but we can quantify them and we can make an, you know, plan how much is required. Similarly, if you look at clothes, you know, how many clothes do you need to protect the body? At one time, you can only wear one pair of clothes. You know, there have been instances of a lot of instances, like, you know, there was this Philippine first lady who had some 3,000 pairs of shoes. But now, really speaking, you can only wear one pair of shoes at a time. So if you see, even for protection, similarly for, you know, when we think of house for shelter, so you can only live in one house at a time. So how many houses do you really need to protect the body? If you look at right utilization of the body, then, you know, like now we are using certain instruments to use, laptop or phone. We might be using speakers, mics, so on. So all this is required in limited quantity, and we can measure it. So what do you feel about this?
Okay.
The quantity of physical facility required, is it definite and limited or indefinite, and we can't find out how much is needed? I'm not able to get even the icons on top, so I'm just not able to see the
poll. I have launched the poll.
I'm sorry, but somebody will have to read it out because I can't see it on my screen at all. So, meanwhile, if anybody has any question on this content that we have just discussed, not much we've discussed, but still, if anybody has any doubt on this, we can take it up while we're waiting for the results of the reflection. All these things that we see, you know, physical facility that we require, all of them, we can, if we explore into this, we will find that we can quantify all of these. once the results are up, can somebody please read them out?
The quantity of physical facility required is definite. Majority have responded in its favor, about 80% of them. So I think the point is taken by them.
Yeah, that's nice. Okay. So the required physical facility can be recognized along with the required quantity is what we are saying. The quantity of food required for nurturing the body, limited or unlimited, clothes, shelter for protecting the body, is it limited or unlimited? Instruments, equipments for right utilization of the body, is that limited or unlimited? And we can, you know, see this also. Identifying the quantity of the physical facility in the next reflection.
Yeah, Didi, reflection is on.
Yeah. Quantity of physical facility required for nurturing. So food, protecting, right utilization. Are these limited in quantity or unlimited in quantity? What is your reflection on this? What is your view on this?
There are two hands raised. You could probably take those two questions.
Yeah. Gajendra, please.
But the answer mic. Is answer. Acha, okay.
Please pass the mic.
Dr. Velumani, Dr. Gopi, and Dr. Satish.
Dr. Velumani, go ahead, please.
Sir, if we say that the quantity of clothes, shelter, equipments, and everything is limited, mm-hmm. if we take it, sometimes this reflects on the growth, is it, ma'am?
Growth meaning?
Because it depends on the desire. The people may want to have a luxury car, then one more car. So if you are limiting this, then our desire may get depressed. Or it is that the natural acceptance, our desire has to be limited. Is it so, ma'am?
No, no, we are not saying that the desires need to be limited. Here I am just mentioning that the need of the body is definite. The need of the body is in required quantity is limited. But when it comes to desire, there can be various other desires in the self. But what is important and what we will come to, you know, as we go further, that if the desires are in line with the natural acceptance, meaning if the desires are based on right understanding, then they are good for us. They are, you know, the right kind of desires. And there's nothing wrong in having the desires. But having desires in line with natural acceptance is one thing. But when we have desires that are conflicting with the natural acceptance, then is when the problems come. Does that answer your question?
Yes, yes, madam. I got it.
Thank you.
Reflection is on the screen.
Now the answers are, everybody, most of the respondents are saying limited in quantity. All three questions have been answered. The quantity of physical facility like food, etc. required for nurturing my body is limited in quantity. This is 94%. And same 93% quantity of physical facility like clothes, shoes, house required to protect my body is limited. Yeah. And so is the case. 98% have responded. Quantity of physical facility like mobiles, cars, instruments or such equipment required to make right utilization of my body is limited in quantity.
Yeah, thank you so much.
It is more than 90%.
Yeah. So it is nice to see everybody is able to see that. So physical facility.
The result was shared, no? Everybody could see it. The result was shared. Gajendra, sir?
Yeah, it was.
Okay.
So physical facility is required to keep the body in good health so that right utilization of the body can be ensured. And physical facility is required only for nurturing, protecting, and rightly utilizing the body. So if you can see that, then we can see that it is required in a limited quantity. And once we can see that the requirement is limited, then we can really understand the meaning of prosperity. So with this background, we'll go and into, you know, what exactly we mean by prosperity. Kumar Bhaiya mentioned this in the morning also, but we'll go over it briefly. Prosperity is the feeling of having or producing more than required physical facility. So what is this for? Like, what is, why more? This more is not for accumulating. This more is for sharing. And this has two parts. One is that I need to identify how much I require. So my identification of the required physical facility. So how much quantity I need. And this, if you remember, we had discussed in the beginning itself when we talked about our basic aspiration that only when we have right understanding are we able to really decide how much we need. So for this, we need right understanding. With that right understanding, we can identify how much of physical facility we need. The second part of this is to make that much available to myself. First, I find out how much I need, and then I ensure that I can make it available. I can produce that much or little more than that, what is required. And for this, I need the right skills. So this is what we have been talking right from the beginning. Skills guided by values. So right skills based on the right understanding. So yes, make it available, produce more, have more, but identify your need. How much do you need? Then based on that, you can decide how much to have. So when you have that feeling that I have sufficient, that's when think of right utilization. You think of nurturing the other person. You can ask yourself, you know, when are you likely to nurture the other person? When you feel prosperous or when you feel deprived? So a prosperous person will think of utilizing correctly, will think of nurturing the other person, while a deprived person will think of accumulating, exploiting the other person. So I gave this example, you know, I was thinking of that example that when I was like a student and we had gone on a trip to a village area, rural area, for just a picnic sort of, we came across this family, a small family, which had some sugarcane fields. So they sort of called us over. Now, we didn't know them. We were going there for the first time. They didn't know us, but they called us over. And they asked us, they welcomed us to their house. They made us sit on the cot outside and they, you know, brought out buckets, 2-3 buckets of sugarcane juice. So we were quite amazed because growing up in the city and all, you're not used to seeing so much, you know, you are used to maybe drinking 1 glass of sugarcane juice, at most 2 glasses. So here they had brought out, you know, buckets full for us. And we had a little bit and they were quite insistent, no, you must have, you hardly had. And they were very, very generous and very sort of welcoming. So, and of course, you know, there was no question of making any payment or something. They just felt, they said something like, you know, you are, it's good that we saw you, and before you go further, at least you should quench your thirst and then go. So scenario. The other scenario can be that we make only as much as is barely sufficient for ourselves at home in the cities. And we, you know, are unable to offer to any guest when they come. So this is why we say that having a little more than required. So if a guest comes and we don't have enough, what are we going to do? Are we going to share with them or are we going to wait? So there is this saying, you know, khaen to jaye is one thing. And the other thing is jaye to khaye. Khaye to jaye means like what I mentioned in the village area. So if somebody is visiting, they feel like they must feed you before you go so that you should not go hungry. The other scenario can be jaye to khaye, that you are waiting, that only when the guest leaves, then you can eat because you don't have enough to offer them. So you think of nurturing and you think of helping, or you think of making the other person also prosperous when you have this feeling of prosperity within you. And you can explore this for yourself. Do you have this? Do you feel that this is right? Or, you know, something different? So the reflection is...
Reflection has been lost.
Huh. The quantity of physical facility I have today, is it not sufficient, that you need more? Is it sufficient? But
no, Didi, something that is mentioned here is physical facilities required for nurturing, protection, and making right utilization of the body.
It's the same.
Okay. So this we already did, right? Same one. Okay. Anyway.
Okay.
So anybody has any question, we can discuss that.
Dr. Velumani, do you have a question?
So I think we took her question. She just has not brought her hand down.
Oh, not put the hand down.
Okay. Okay. Dr. Balasubramanian? Go ahead, please.
Sir,
go ahead.
Hello.
Go ahead.
Yes, please go ahead. Go ahead, please. Hello. Is there a question related to this content?
I think Didi, we can move.
Yeah, maybe we can move ahead because there's not much time left. So previously we had seen two categories are there of human beings. Those that lack physical facility are unhappy and deprived. And then there are those who have physical facility and still are unhappy and deprived. And we said we wanted to have physical facility and be happy and prosperous. So now you can see that if that identification of the required physical facility is missing, then one can only shift between this category one and two. So like, you know, we earlier, I think Kumar Bhaiya might have given this example that, you know, if you have a cup which is doesn't have the bottom, then, you know, no matter how much of tea you put in it, it will not be enough. So if we don't know how much we need, if that identification of how much is required is not there, if that is missing, then we keep feeling that we are deprived, we don't have enough. So even though whether we have or we don't have, we still feel unhappy and deprived. But if we want to be in that third state where we have physical facility and we are happy and prosperous, this is only possible when we have the right identification and we make available, you know, a little more than we require. So, today, the state is, there is this misunderstanding, this you have seen this morning also, that we are assuming the self to be the body. Because we are not aware of the self, we think we are the body. So because of that, even though we have needs in the self, we correlate them with the body needs. So for instance, if I had a need, if I have a need for respect, I equate it to my clothes or I equate it to food. So I wear fancy clothes so that I might get respect. And we saw just, you know, a few minutes back that this doesn't really bring respect. This brings more like jealousy. Similarly, I might go to a fancy restaurant to eat. I might give the waiter a very big tip thinking that I will get respect. But respect is a need of the self. While I'm trying to fulfill that need of the self through a body need because I'm not aware of the self. And if I look further, this need of the self is continuous. So can I fulfill a continuous need with something that is limited? So I can't. So if I try to fulfill also, it doesn't happen. So, you know, I want that continuous taste in my mouth. So I keep eating, but then it's not going to last. How long will it last? Only as long as the food is on the tongue, where the taste buds are. Once it goes in, the taste is gone. But that need is continuous, so I keep trying to, you know, have more and more so that I can fulfill this continuous need, and it doesn't happen. So I feel like my needs are unlimited. So I keep accumulating more and more. And still, I feel I don't have enough because my need for the self has not been fulfilled. And we saw earlier that the needs of the self are fulfilled within the self by the feelings of right understanding and right feeling. So when I don't have this fulfillment of the self and I'm trying to go through the body, then I keep feeling deprived. And that's when this whole loop comes about that you saw earlier. That feeling of deprivation that I don't have enough, that makes me want to make effort for more physical facility. And this could be by any means sometimes. I try as hard as possible to earn more money, to buy more. And I end up accumulating and still I feel deprived. I feel like I still don't have enough. So then this cycle goes on and on. And we asked if, you know, you can check if you think you are in that loop. And I don't think we will stop for questions. We'll just quickly go to the health of the body. Here, again, this feeling of self-regulation to bring about, you know, this harmony of self with body. So when there is this feeling of self-regulation, we can have health in the body. Health, when we say health of the body, we mean that the body acts according to the self and the parts of the body are in harmony, they are in order.